Hello, it's your favorite sports dunk here. Don't forget to hit that subscribe button to join the fastest growing community on YouTube. Remember, Nightcap doesn't happen without you. So please subscribe or you're going to make Ocho cry. I believe Sean McDermott is taking this Buffalo team as far as he can take them.
You think so?
I do. I think he's taking them as far as he can take them.
So would you really want a coaching change, being that they're always in contention and always having an opportunity?
It's not enough to be in contention.
Reaching the AFC Championship. They're only two games away every year.
Exactly.
They're only two games a year every year. Do you really want to make
Are we any closer? Are we any closer than we were last year? Are we any closer than we were the year before? Are we any closer? So is the job to be two games away every single year, or is the job to finish the task?
I mean, honestly, regardless of who the coaching is, there's one special piece. And you know how those special pieces are on each team that will always have you in contention, regardless of who's at the helm.
It's not good enough to be in contention.
Huh?
It's not good enough to be in contention.
Okay.
Think about now you got Josh Allen. He's about to be almost $50 million against the cap.
Right.
The past 3 years, he was sub $20 million under the cap. Now he's about to be almost $50 million.
They're gonna manipulate the numbers and just give them and upload it into a they're gonna upload some of that
probably
money.
Give it to him in a signing bonus. Spread it out.
They're gonna work it.
Yeah.
I see what you mean though. I don't know about a coaching change though. I don't know about a coaching change.
Why not?
In those moments, the game, especially the game, always, and you say it all the time, it's the decision making in those moments that matter.
What about that fourth and five? He went for it over 25. What about that fourth and five?
They could overcome that with the decision making. If he threw that goddamn shallow to Diggs, where he was wide open instead of trying to hit the home run and just be the guy. Take what they give you. Decision making in the moments of a football game, there are two or three plays that change the dynamic of the game that only matter. If you run 68, only three plays matter. As crazy as that may sound. And those two or three plays, he made the wrong decision with the ball.
Yeah. And your guy made the wrong decision going for it on fourth down. Now, your defense bailed you out because McCole Harmon's stretching the ball and he knocks it out, which is a horrible rule. You can't punish the offense that severely. Mm-hmm. The ball goes out. Let's just say now, instead of the defense getting the ball, if they don't recover it, now you put the offense back on the 20. So instead of being on the 5 or 6 yard line, you don't give the ball to the offense because they didn't recover it.
Right.
How do you reward somebody for something that they didn't do?
Didn't do. Yeah, you're right. I'm sure that maybe the competition committee get to that this offseason and change it.
Yeah. I believe that's too harsh of a penalty for the offense. Now, if the defense jumps on, obviously, if the defense jumps on the ball in the end zone, it's a touchback. But if they knock the ball out of the end zone, they haven't recovered it. So how do they get the ball? I think that was an asinine rule, a dumb rule to begin with.
Yeah.
So hopefully they do something with that. But, you know, in sports history, hey, everybody wants to have their Joe Montana, their Joe Namath number where you guarantee a victory. Joe Namath moment where they guarantee a victory. Mm-hmm. But – sports is littered with guys making promises that they could not keep.
Oh, so like politicians, basically.
Yes. trolls are in the chat saying we aren't live. Dumb dumbs, we're on the West Coast. We started about 7:10, which means it's 10:10 East Coast time. So we are absolutely live. So now it's 7:40.
They don't realize we live.
You know, there are people that get on and they want to troll and they think they're so smart and they're like, y'all not even live. Look what time it is.
Oh,
yeah,
because we normally do it later, the later hour. Okay.
Yeah. So Bills kicker Tyler Bass deactivated all of his social media accounts after receiving death threats over the missed kick. Let me ask you a question. Ocho, let's just say for the sake of argument.
Yes, sir.
He makes that kick. So that means Patrick Mahomes has 1 minute, 47 seconds, and 3 timeouts. Now, we saw Patrick Mahomes go get in field goal range in 13 seconds.
Yeah.
Now, y'all do realize Patrick Mahomes was moving the ball up and down the field. Y'all do realize that, right?
Y'all made
them punt one time.
At will.
Y'all made them punt one time in the entire game. So now all of a sudden, you have the utmost confidence in your defense.
Mm-hmm. Listen, if he did make that and it was a tie game, yeah, with a minute and some change to go,
yes,
they was going that. Mahomes was marching down that field based on the resume and based on what we've seen before.
We just saw the man go get a field goal, Ocho, with 13 seconds.
Seconds, yeah. Yeah. Yeah, and especially with the way that offense is playing, with the emergence of Rashee Rice.
Right.
Obviously, Kelsey played very well. Pacheco played very well. They were going to get it. They were going to get it. So either way, I think the result would have been the same, even if he had made it.
And it's not like you guys had, you know, the fearsome foursome or the steel curtains, like you guys were generating this great pressure. Like y'all had already sacked Mahomes like 6 times last night.
Right.
You hadn't. So I would trust Mahomes in that situation, but they taking this game way too serious. Y'all gonna threaten a man's life. Y'all threaten a man's life or the man's family. Come on now.
You know how that go now. You know how the fans are. You know how the fans are very fickle. They when you winning. And when you're responsible for a win, they love you.
You know what?
When you cost your team a game to go to the AFC Championship, you already know how the fan. Listen, they don't forgive. They don't. They're not gonna forgive. Not right now. Not right now.
So
they hurting that.
What if you on your job and you mess up and somebody call your phone? I'm gonna kill your punk ass.
If they said to me.
Yeah, anybody, just people. The people at a normal job.
Let's use me for example. Use me for example.
Yeah, so, you mess up.
Hold on. Ring, 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 ring. Okay, now say it. Say what you're gonna say.
Hey, you fucked up at work today. I'm gonna kill your punk ass.
Well, bring your bitch ass down here then and do it then.
I am too. Wait, I see Rail. Well, I tell you what, I bet you Rail better not go out that house tonight. And your kids, I know where your kids go to school at too. Old peanut head ass.
Yeah, I'm glad you know where my kids go to school. How about you pull up there and I guarantee security going to handle you. And
security
Rail,
gonna
she all right. Hey, listen, Rail got her gun license, so you're going to have to deal with that. A hot one in your ass. Now what?
Yeah, and guess what? Security can't be at all the places at one time. You know you got limb kids. So you got limb kids, your punk ass, and Rail. I got something for all of you.
Ha, that's what you didn't know. All my kids got a gun license, and they all carry.
They ain't got nothing.
Ha, now what?
They ain't got nothing. And I better not catch you slipping either. I got something for you too, mainly.
I'm gonna tell you where I'm gonna be at. I'm gonna be at the McDonald's on 62nd Street at 12:30. So meet me there.
That's why your head look like shaved monkey nuts.
Hey, that's a good one. That's a good one. Hey, but listen, on a serious note, you know what Tyler Bass need to do? I wouldn't delete nothing. I wouldn't delete nothing.
No.
Well, what I would have done to
got the authorities involved.
Nation, I would have made an Instagram post on Instagram and Twitter apologizing to my teammates, apologizing to my coaches, and apologizing to the city of Buffalo. Not going in hiding.
No.
Continue to live your life. It's still a game. And again, the game is about moments. And just you fail short in the moment. I'm sure there will be other times if you have the job next year as a kicker where you can rebound and redeem yourself. But don't go in the hide. Don't go deactivating social media. Send the apology out and keep on living your life, man. You live to see another day. Don't go in the hide. Don't go in the hide. Don't go in the running, man. Don't do that.
But Ocho, remember I told you in 91, had we had social media, I dropped the touchdown.
Yeah. Oh, they would lit your ass up. Boy.
Hey,
they would let you have it. It's a part of the territory now. It's a part of the territory.
You understand it? Yes. Yes. But shout out to Bills Mafia, who started donating to a local nonprofit, 10 Lives Club, to show support for Bass. He's the brand ambassador for the organization, which is a no-kill cat rescue and shelter. So Bills Mafia, look, there's always going to be one or two jackasses that think, it's the end-all, be-all, that my life is changed all of a sudden because we lost the football game.
Right.
And they take it too far, and they start threatening people's lives or their family lives and things of that nature.
Right.
But kudos to the Bills Mafia, because most of those guys are really good. They do that. This fan base, They support, hey, something happens.
Causes oh, something happens.
They're great. They're great. Very good. So I can't say enough, I can't say enough great things about Bills Mafia, because for the most part, all they want to do is jump off Winnebagoes on the tables, burning tables, power slam somebody, and go watch their team hopefully normally win football games. But there are always a few dum-dums in every fan base that take it far too serious, like all of a sudden that they were out there. You didn't.
Right.
And so kudos to Bill Mafia to donate to his local charity, 10 Lives Club, to show support for Bass. Hey, bro, pick your head up.
Yeah.
Pick your head up. All of them. The greats, all the greats have missed a field goal at some point that probably cost their team a game.
Yeah.
Whether it's Tuck at Baltimore, Adam Vinatieri, whomever, it does not matter. If you're a field goal kicker, you're going to have this. Every quarterback has thrown a pick to end the game. A running back has fumbled. A receiver has dropped a pass. It's not the end-all, be-all, but it's about how you bounce back from your lowest moment. Yeah. When you're at your absolute lowest, what are you going to do, Tyler Bass, to respond?
Yeah. Yeah.
Get back. Hey, get back on the horse. The horse throw your ass off. Get back on it.
Don't
get
hide,
out there.
Though.
Start kicking. Hey,
don't hide.
Put yourself, don't hide. Put yourself right back in that moment. Now, you can't replicate that, but hey, all of a sudden, every kick is we're down three and we need this kick.
Yeah.
Different angles, 35, 40, 45, 40. 50 yards. Hey,
regardless of the conditions.
Absolutely. Absolutely.